Hello, and welcome to the explanation part of this video. I hope you enjoyed that cinematic, as it took quite a while to make. But without any further stalling, let's get on with the explanation. So, you start with filling the input. In this chest right here, you would place down a concrete powder. But if you have shulker boxes of concrete, you can put them in this chest right here. But you will need to place down the first shulker in order to start the unloading. The player would place the concrete powder against this waterlogged stair, which would then turn into concrete and get pushed forward by this piston into here, where it would activate the zero tick generator, making these pistons fire instantly, pushing the blocks into the blast chamber. This observer would detect when the layer is full, sending a signal to this piston, pushing up this observer that would then power these rails, updating these observers, that would then power these pistons. This observer also would activate this counter, which basically just makes it so that the TNT waits a few layers before activating and blowing up the concrete. The concrete later drop down here into this water and get flushed into this 2x loader. The reason why I'm using a 2x loader is because this converter makes 18,000 items per hour, and a single hopper can only transfer 9,000 per hour, which means I need two of them in order to match the speed. This comparator is powered by signal strength 15 from this torch, meaning that it would only send a signal if this box is full. The shulker box that got broken would travel to this dropper tower and go up into the storage. To minimize lag, I have locked almost every single hopper in this converter, all in the storage but the top one, so that when you request a shulker box and the farm is off, the box will always arrive in the top chest, like this. Now that we know how the converter works, let's take a closer look at some of its components, starting with how to align the hopper minecart that sucks the items from the shulker box. So you start by placing a chest like this, a rail like this. Then you place the hopper minecart so that it runs into this chest. Then you place two blocks like this, pistons to push it down, and boom, you're done. Now if you were to throw a stack of anything, it would get divided into this hopper and this hopper. Zero ticking blocks. How does it work and do you really need it? When this piston gets updated by the blocks incoming, it activates a zero tick generator, sending a super fast pulse through this redstone line into these pistons, which push forward the blocks. But do you really need something like this for a concrete converter? Short answer, yes. Long answer, the player can only place blocks every 4 game ticks. This zero tick generator makes these pistons power and then retract at 3 game ticks, making it possible for the player to keep placing without having to wait for pistons to retract. Some of you may be wondering how I got the signal from this note block down into this loader. If you have a wall set up like this, and you place a block next to it, it will change shape all the way down from that block. And this shape changing can be detected by an observer at the bottom of it, making it possible to send a signal from world height to bedrock almost instantly if you so wish to. Some of you may be asking yourselves, how does this observer power these three pistons? Well, it's due to something called quasi-connectivity. If you power this block, not only will the blocks that are touching it power, but also the blocks a bit under it. This can be easily demonstrated by this. Now, when I power this block, you would expect these three pistons to power, right? Because they are touching the block. Which they do. And these three are not touching the block. So they shouldn't. Now, what if I place a nut block right here? You would expect these three pistons to not power because they are still not touching that block. Well, watch what happens. They do power. This nut block is updating the pistons so that they know that they are being powered by quasi-connectivity. Powering a piston is simple. You just place the redstone block next to it. But what if you have to place the redstone block one block higher? It's not touching the piston, so you would think that the piston is not being powered. But watch what happens when I update it. It just realized that it's being powered by this redstone block. Now, because there's nothing to update it, when I remove it, it does not realize that it just got its power source removed until you update it, which would then cause it to retract. Though please note, this behavior only applies to pistons, droppers, and dispensers. You may have noticed that on my channel there are no tutorials for my farms. The main reason for this is that I don't feel like making them. Though in this video, and hopefully the ones to come, I will be making a compromise. And by that I mean, using Lightmatica to show you each layer of the farm, so you can rebuild it just by pausing the video. Here are all the blocks needed to build the concrete converter. Enjoy the music, and I will hopefully see you next time.